Hi everyone. Welcome to the virtual class of learning. Today we are going to learn about grade 7 civics lesson 1 on equality. So let us look at the stories which are given for us before we get into the details. So in the first picture you can see a group of people standing in a line for casting their vote. You can also see the names of the people who are standing there. If I am not wrong, something like Manjit Kaur, who is a teacher, Teja Singh, who is a trader, Girish Rao, who is a student, Kanta Devi, domestic worker, Sujata Kumari is also a domestic worker. So on the election day, you can see all categories of people standing in the same line and ready to vote or cast their vote. But going on, as the day goes ahead, Kanta gets a doubt about her understanding. What is equality? Is it really equal? Because when it came to voting, they were given option to stand equally and vote. But when it comes to day-to-day work, are we actually following equality? That is a doubt what she expresses as the day progresses. I will vote for the candidate who has promised to bring pipe water to our area. This is what Kanta expresses. Well, we will see. There is a reply what she gets. Afterwards, she sees Gudiya has been running fever and I have to take her to the hospital. But I will have to finish the work at the Sahib's house first and ask for some advance of money, because the child is not feeling well. He need to be taken to an hospital. It's no wonder that Gudiya falls ill often. Why? Because the basti or the area where they stay is never cleaned. It is mostly dirty. So obviously there are chances for children to become unhealthy. So after looking at the both case studies, we understand that Kanta is having political equality, that is right to vote, but economic equality is not there. Now, right to equality or equal right to vote. Let us focus on this point first. The story above begins with Kanta standing in a line to cast her vote. Look again at the various people who are standing in the line with her. Kanta recognizes her employer, Ashok Jain, and Chotte Lal, her neighbor. In a democratic country like India, all adults, irrespective of what religion they belong to, how much education they have had, what caste they are, or whether they are rich or poor, are allowed to vote. That is the main feature of democratic countries. That is called universal adult franchise, which is an essential aspect of all democracies. The idea of universal adult franchise is based on the idea of equality, because it states that every adult in a country, irrespective of their wealth and the communities he or she belongs to, has one vote. Kanta is excited to vote and happy that she is equal to all the others because each of them has one vote. But as her day goes on, Kanta becomes less certain about what is equality really means. What is it that makes Kanta unsure about equality? So in this session, we learned about the concept of right to vote, universal adult franchise, which is an essential feature of democracy. Every individual in a democratic country like India, irrespective of their caste, color, creed, region, religion, can vote, and each vote will have same value. So this makes Kanta feel very happy initially in the morning, and she feels she is equal to all the others. But as the day progresses, she becomes little bit uncertain about the concept of equality. What makes Kanta uncertain and unsure of equality, we'll be looking in session 2. Stay tuned, catch you in session 2.